Yes. Good evening, everyone. I welcome you all on behalf of NASI and Dr. Homi Bhabha State University, the Insura Science and Insura Science Alumni Association, for this webinar on spinal cord injury and rehabilitation. I request Dr. Hassan, sir, to enlighten us about the NASI. Over to Dr. Hassan, sir. So you can.
Thank you, madam. And very good afternoon to all of you. First of all, on behalf of the National Academy of Sciences India, and on my personal behalf, I would like to welcome you all for this wonderful event. I will say a unique event in terms of NASI's initiative called the Spinal Cord Injury and Rehabilitation. So I must say that the National Academy of Sciences India is the oldest science academy in India, which is established in the year 1930, and has been undertaking various activities for the promotion of science and technologies, as well as to bring awareness among the public the developments in the area of science and technology and connection of the scientific achievements and its relevance to the societal programs. So in this regard, the NASI has been taking up various activities such as webinars or even workshops, seminars, conferences, and many other activities in various places, and with a relevance to the connecting the science with the society in at large. So the Mumbai chapter of the NASI has several chapters across India, and the Mumbai chapter of the National Academy of Sciences India has taken a lead in conducting various activities such as seminars and other programs. And in this connection, we have been in discussing in the Executive Council, and Professor Yakmi sir has indicated that we will carry out something different, something unique as compared to the activities what we have been holding regularly. Especially in the area of the spinal cord injury and rehabilitation. And I am very happy to say that today we were able to organize this event with the active support from the Institute of Science, Dr. Homi Bhabha State University, and the Institute of Science Alumni Association, who has kindly agreed to host this event on behalf of the NASI Mumbai chapter, and carry out these proceedings further. Thank you, Gayatri Madam, for all your initiatives, and also the Institute of Science Alumni Association and the entire Institute of Science Management for taking up this initiative in hosting this event. And of course, thank you to Yakmi sir for taking this, for bringing us, connecting with the Ketana Madam and the NASI Mumbai chapter for carry out this event. Now, with this, I will request Dr. Yakmi sir to take the proceedings. Sir, you are muted.
Thank you for pointing it out. Okay, good afternoon, everybody. It's a happy occasion for us that, as Dr. Hassan said, that we have embarked upon a new kind of orientation to the activities of our seminars, which we normally do in terms of typically academic scientific activity. This is an awareness program, because I have been discussing with my friends that the level of awareness about spinal cord injuries, even in academics, is not enough. They should know. So today's program has been organized by NASI, National Academy of Sciences of India. It is, as you know, awareness program on spinal cord injury and rehabilitation. The hosts, as I mentioned, for this online program are the Homi Bhabha State University, Mumbai, the Institute of Science, Mumbai, and Institute of Science Alumni Association. Some of you who may be wondering about this Dr. Homi Bhabha State University name. It's a cluster university set up by the government in 2019, just about 2 years ago. And Institute of Science is now under this new cluster university, which is called Dr. Homi Bhabha State University. And that university incorporates Institute of Science, Elphinstone College, and Sydenham College. Most of you are familiar with the names of these colleges. But more than that, we are familiar with the Institute of Science, set up in 1920, heritage institution and heritage building. We are all very proud of having entered it so many times again and again. And we really love when we are there. And Dr. Mathur and some older colleagues like me, we must have come there dozens of times.
My father-in-law was director there.
Yes, you are right. Dr. Mata Prasad was his father-in-law, who was a director for a few years of Institute of Science. Okay. So under this program, we shall have a keynote address and four short presentations. You already know about it, you have seen. I think some pickup is coming. Maybe my case. Ketna, can you mute yourself? It is coming from your side. Okay. I hope now it will not come. So the keynote address is, speaker is Dr. Ketna Mehta. She is a founder trustee of Neena Foundation. On the topic of today, her topic of lecture will be spinal cord injury, a devastating and incurable permanent disability. Under this talk, her broad focus will be how one gets a spinal cord injury. Mostly people get it when they are quite all right and some accident happens or something else happens and they get it. And how do you prevent it and what steps are needed towards rehabilitation of survivors of spinal cord injuries? I have known Dr. Ketna Mehta for several years and she's an excellent speaker. She's a PhD in healthcare, specifically on spinal cord injury rehabilitation management. Before that, she had topped in Mumbai University in Masters in Marketing Management, MMM, which she did from Jamnalal Bajaj Institute. She's a fellow of the Institute of Management Consultants. Ketna suffered a spinal cord injury herself about 26 years ago. Before that, he was not a special person like most of us are not special persons. What happened? How she got it? She was on a paragliding trip near Bombay somewhere. She had a mishap and then her life, she had this injury and ever since she has been on the wheelchair. Since then, her life has revolved around how she can bring relief to people with spinal cord injury across India. To channelize her efforts, she has established Naina Foundation in 2001, about 20 years ago. It's an NGO as a trustee. It is named after her late sister Neena, who was a doctor and she died some years ago. Neena Foundation has a mission to rehabilitate people with spinal cord injuries. In this, Ketna has active support of her family, particularly her brother Dhaval Mehta, whom I also have met at some functions like this. Ketna is a professor in management and a thought leader on disability solutions, a role in which I have seen her often at ADAPT in Bandra Reclamation. That's where we have been meeting. ADAPT handles the disabilities of all kinds. It is close to the C-Link bridge. She's an author writing regularly on rehabilitation of spinal cord injury people and an editor on this theme for the magazine called One World. It had an issue yesterday she sent to me. New issue has come. She served as a regional consultant for the research project editor for two magazines, Design for All and Success and Ability. Dr. Ketna Mehta has won the prestigious Helen Keller Award. It's called NCP EDP Helen Keller Award, as well as the Women Achiever Award from the Money Life Daily, which comes daily newspaper. Before I invite Dr. Ketna Mehta to make her presentation, it is my pleasure to inform the audience and viewers of this program that after her address, we have lined up short presentations by four speakers, all of whom are members of the executive committee of Nina Foundation. I want to call out their names and tell their title of their talk so that the audience knows who they are. If it is possible, kindly do help me in that. So first one will be Ms. Sunita Sancheti. She will be speaking on physiotherapy, OT and aquatherapy. Can we have her on the screen? Or maybe sometime later. She was there. Some hiccup. Okay. Now, the second person to speak will be Mr. Sheikh. He will speak on case study of rehabilitation of an unprivileged spinal cord injury person. Mr. Sheikh also has been instrumental in rehabilitating our third speaker, Mr. Oliver D'Souza, who is right now in New Zealand. So it is midnight there. He cannot be present physically in our meeting here. So he has recorded about 8 or 9 minutes video and sent to her, something worth watching and listening to. The last speaker in this series will be Ms. Neenu Kevlani, on role of government or corporate sectors in rehabilitation of spinal cord injury people. Let me add that except one speaker today, all others are on wheelchairs. So this is a meeting spoken to by wheelchair users. And let me also now finally thank Professor Gayatri Barbade from Institute of Science, who has been with us for the last 2 or 3 days trying to fix up the organization of this meeting. And we have here her team. She is the coordinator of Environment Science Department, Professor Gayatri Barbade. And then we have Professor Aparna Saraf, Department of Botany and Secretary of the Alumni Association of Institute of Science, of which Professor Thakkar is the president. We have Ms. Jogita Kanapalli. Everybody has been asking her help from her, including Ketna Mehta, who is smiling. Every 2 hours, it is Jogita who comes to our rescue. Then Dr. Mihir Herlekar and Mr. Akshay Dange. These three are, the last three names are assistant professors in Environment Science Department of Institute of Science. I give my compliments to all of them for having helped us out in organizing this meeting. I hand over the meeting now to the other organizers.
Sir, I would request Dr. Thakkar, sir, please speak about the Alumni Association.
Oh, we'll be glad to listen to him.
Thakkar, sir, we would like to hear from you.
Good evening. Yeah. I'm sorry, I'm unable to switch on my camera. So you will only hear my voice and not see me personally. I'll not take much of your time. Alumni Association was formed long back, right in the years of Golden Jubilee, 1970, of the Institute of Science. Later on, it remained dormant for quite some time and then was revived in 2003 when we were to appear before the NEC. So Alumni Association since then has been quite active, participating in many activities of the Institute. I would not like to take much of your time because I'm as curious as you all are to listen to Dr. Mehta. So thank you very much. And on behalf of the Alumni Association, once again, I welcome Professor Dr. Yakmi, Dr. Mehta, and all the speakers and all dignitaries in the audience. Thank you very much. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you, Thakkar, sir. Over to Mehta, madam.
Namaste and good evening. Dr. Yakhni, I bow before you and thank you for this privilege to create awareness amongst the elite scientific fraternity. Nina Foundation team, my source of strength and energy, Sunita, Neenu, Mr. Mohammed Sheikh, and Oliver are all going to. And I wish that all of you stay till the end, because each one of them are going to shake you up. And at the end of it, I'll ask you, how much were you shaken and stirred? So please, and if possible, and if you don't have an issue, do put on your videos, because we would love to see your smiling faces. Dr. Yakni, I must tell you that years ago, I met Dr. Abdul Kalam at Rashtrapati Bhavan, and I must say that you shared one thing with him, besides, of course, the tremendous wisdom and knowledge that you have, which is the humbleness and the understanding of spinal cord injury. So really, truly, what you've done for Nina Foundation is worth several bows. Thank you so much, Dr. Yakni, for the wonderful introduction as well. My gratitude to NASI, Dr. Hassan, Indian Institute of Science, the young, efficient team, Professor Gayatri, Professor Jogita, Professor Aparna, alumni, and other stakeholders, especially Ajay and Mihir. I always see creative ways to communicate about spinal cord injury and create awareness about it, because our objective is to create interest in us, the ones who are living with spinal cord injury, a permanent, incurable, most devastating disability. So let me do this creatively. We all love watching movies, right? They are a great way to communicate about a healthcare condition in an entertaining form. Here are some of the popular movies on paraplegics and quadriplegics, emotively bringing out the tremendous life challenges.
Color?
The highest grosser movie of all times, Avatar, from Hollywood, had Jake Sully, a paraplegic marine, as the main protagonist. Guzarish from India, Bollywood heartthrob Hrithik Roshan amazingly performed as Ethan Mascarenhas, a quadriplegic. The Intouchables French movie had the lovable Philip as a quadriplegic. A very popular Indian regional film star, Dulquer Salman, played a photographer with spinal cord injury in a Malayalam film, Kulante Bharya. And of course, our lovable Superman, Christopher Reeves, who played a cop with spinal cord injury in Above Suspicion. The same year, he had a horse riding accident in 95. Coincidentally, the same year, I too had my spinal cord injury. From movies and real life, let me draw your attention to our heroes in real life, all living legends. Over the years, the highest civilian awards from India, both the Padma Bhushan, Padma Shri, have been conferred upon Major HPS Aluwalia, Chairman of Indian Spinal Injury Center, New Delhi, who has quadriplegia and who has scaled Mount Everest before his spinal cord injury. A million salutes. Mr. S. Ramakrishna from Amar Seva Sangam, Javed Ahmed Tak, both received the Padma Shri recently. You must have seen it on YouTube in 2020. We all watch Kaun Banega Crorepati? And the very popular show hosted by Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, a global actor, had two karma yogis, Naveen Gulia, ex-army, and Deepa Malik, the first Indian woman to win a medal in the Paralympics in 2016. They were both on the show. Do you know what is common amongst all of them? They all have a spinal cord injury. I hope you will connect to what I'm saying better now because you have an image in your mind. Because we all like celebrities, right? Ketna Mehta kaun, Sunita Sancheti kaun, Neenu Kevlani kaun, Oliver D'Souza kaun. So, abhi, you will be able to connect better. I hope I've got your interest. There are 1.5 million Indians currently living with spinal cord injury and millions globally. Our Nina Foundation's grassroots rehabilitation work for 21 years surprises us each time when we counsel the new rural and urban poor friends with spinal cord injury and discover the variety of ways in which spinal cord injury happens. Madhu rolled from a terrace when she was barely 2 years old. Dinkle, at 6 years, was in the Bhuj earthquake. Mr. N.D. Tharap, who's now 93 years old, had the house roof falling on his head. Javed Ben Cheda was in a religious procession when a tree branch fell on her. A young friend, Kissin, whom Mr. Mohammed Sheikh is going to talk about as a live case study, fell into an open manhole in our city, Mumbai. Chirag Chauhan was in a train blast. Sunita Sancheti had a benign tumor, and post-surgery, she has spinal cord injury since a very young age. Bullet injuries, electric shock, lightning strikes, air pockets in an aircraft, leaning or, you know, falling from the balcony, losing balance, fall from a tree, ladder, construction site, electric pole. While walking in a village and a bull runs into you. Yes, this also causes a spinal cord injury. Road accidents, swimming, diving, Ganpati Visarjan. We have Pankaj Solanki, whom Mr. Mohammed Sheikh recently visited at Versova. Dahi Handi, our festivals. Stampede at large gatherings, sports, adventure, fall from camel or horse. Traumatic causes are 90%, and diseases of the spine, like cancer or TB, are significantly growing. Our young friends, Sanika, Suraj, Prashant, Tanya, all have tumor of the spine. And then, as kids, they not only suffer cancer, but then they have a life with a spinal cord injury. Spinal cord injury can happen to anyone, anytime, anywhere, any age, any place. It's not from birth. It's incurable. There is no cure. Billions of dollars worldwide is being poured into research for a cure. In fact, Elon Musk, the Tesla guy, with his Neuralink, has also been making news in recent times. What is the solution? A small 14-letter word, but with a huge impact. Can you guess what the word is? Rehabilitation. Yes, you can count. It's a 14-letter word. To improve and have a good quality of life and with as much as independent living skills as possible. What is spinal cord injury rehab? Rehabilitation at 7 levels, which is an outcome of my PhD thesis. Physical, what Sunita will speak to you about. physiotherapy, physiotherapy, more physiotherapy, occupation therapy, aqua therapy. Lifelong. All of us have a schedule. We all do. Besides the regular work, we spend an hour each day. Sunita for 30 years, me for 26 years. Everyone has to do physiotherapy. Psychological rehabilitation, so important, right? So very important. Because to accept and get out of the denial stage is also very important. Vocational rehab, all of us are busy 24/7. That is very important make ourselves realize our self-worth. Social rehabilitation, recreational rehabilitation, and spiritual rehabilitation. These are the seven rehabilitation levels. Why make a big deal about spinal cord injury rehabilitation? What happens post a traumatic or a non-traumatic spinal cord injury? 8 impacts, and I'm going to take you through each one of them. It's very important because all of you belong to the scientific fraternity, and we wish you to get more aware about this. The human anatomy impact. Imagine someone who had experienced only fever, a headache, a bruise, is now paralyzed without sensation from the level of fracture. It could be cervical, dorsal, or lumbar. Cervical, mid is dorsal, and back is lumbar. We cannot get up on our own. If you ask me to get up, I'm using my palms, but I'm unable to get up. Because we don't have the muscle power. We cannot even move our toes. We cannot move our ankle. Some of us cannot lift our knees by ourselves. We have to use our hands to move it. The life of the entire family and the one affected turns 360 degrees upside down. Spinal cord injury is much more devastating than any other disability. Says who? Says who? World Health Organization. When the spinal cord is damaged, the communication between the brain and the body is disrupted, resulting in loss of movement and sensation from the level of injury. Spinal cord injury is much more than not able to walk. It affects basic bodily functions, such as loss of sensation, can cause breathing difficulties and inability to control body temperature, amongst many other things. For bladder voiding of urine, a catheter is either inserted each time or there is an indwelling catheter. That means the bladder is also affected. For regular movement, we have to have measured quantities at fixed schedules, fibrous food, no indulgence. Chalo, aaj Sunita ke yahan chole puri hai, ki Neenu ke yahan dal pakwan hai aur kha liya. Measured food, fibrous food, no indulgence, so that there are no bowel accidents. In the initial phase, not to have control over your basic routine activity comes as a shock. A grown-up person literally shitting in our pants. The family too has to adjust to this new reality, and urine leakages and bowel accidents create a strain in family relations too, especially when homes are small. Most Indian rural homes have community washrooms far away. Sometimes तो खेतों में जाते हैं अभी भी. हम भले ना मार्स में पहुंचा दिया हो कि चंद्रायन भी आ गया हो, लेकिन this is the reality, right? Most of the community washrooms have Indian style washrooms. As persons with spinal cord injury don't have trunk balance, very rarely paraplegics can squat with their crutches. It is relearning a different method and adjusting to this new reality for everyone in the household. On top of that, there is no sensation of mosquito bite, ant bite, hot or cold water, pressure. If I sit on something, we will not know. As both the motor nerves and the sensory nerves are in trauma, dono taraf se, so the synapse is not functioning. Number two, psychological impact. To come to terms with the new reality and accept this life-altering change, the parents during counseling always ask, "Mera bacha kab chalega? When will my child start walking?" The entire life ahead, whether a child, youth, women or elderly, turns topsy-turvy, to accept and come to terms with this is compounded due to the fact that there is no psychological counseling offered post-spine injury or post-spine surgery. Everywhere there is a surgery, but after that, no psychological counseling. Youngsters are embarrassed to be seen on a wheelchair or with scoliosis or with thin legs. So much so that homes, buildings, outside built environment, even hospitals are not wheelchair friendly, which Nino is going to talk about today, and becomes a frustrating period, compounding lives. Educational impact. The initial vigorous rehabilitation for 2 years and lack of enough awareness about rehabilitation centers takes a long period to learn to manage bladder, bowel schedules, and most schools, colleges, coaching classes, hospitals, homes are not wheelchair accessible. So all the more frustrating. Schools do not allow mothers to visit to help the young child with catheterization in the initial phase, and so are socially distanced from the regular and co-curricular activities. Employment impact. Nina Foundation counsels and supports rural and urban poor friends who were doing physical labor earlier. Farmers, road building, construction sites. And it's so difficult because they were the sole earning members. It's very interesting to know that the disability pension in the state of Maharashtra is ₹1,200 per month. Convert that into dollars, $13 a month. Tell us, what can we do in ₹1,200 a month? Catheter ka kharcha bhi nahi niklega. Number five, social impact. Temples, parks, shops, religious functions, weddings, each and every aspect of life becomes out of bounds. You are socially cut off from all human connect. Many people are just lying at home, watching their ceiling. Recreational impact, cricket grounds, play areas, badminton and tennis courts, swimming pools, changing areas, clubs, gymkhanas are not equipped. And so we are cut from all kinds of outdoor sports. Oliver is going to speak to you about this. Spiritual impact. The Indian society mentions karma, that you must have done something really very bad in your previous janam. And this is your state of affairs. It shakes the faith and belief and takes much time for our team at Nina Foundation and elsewhere to redesign the thinking and move ahead. Number 8, secondary complications impact. Mr. Mohammed Sheikh will tell you, in the lifetime of a person with spinal cord injury, there are so many secondary complications, and I am going to list them down for you. Many a times turning fatal. Pressure, bed sores, urinary tract infections, spasms, conjunctures, swelling and edema, autonomic dysreflexia, surge in blood pressure, kidney stones, kidney failure, need for dialysis, burnt skin due to electric blanket or hot water, or keeping a hot beverage or plate on your thighs, or sitting on a hot surface like a cab parked in sunlight. Osteoporosis, anxiety attacks, depression, stress, fractures, spondylosis, frozen shoulder, falls during transfers, fatigue of the muscles due to overuse, tennis elbow, Rajashree Patil has it permanently, diaper rash, catheter injury, constipation, piles, fissures, need for surgeries like penile implant in nails for fertility and removal of uterus in females due to heavy bleeding and dependence on a caregiver. All this due to a fracture in the spine, a small episode, ek hadse ki wajah se. Medical texts, research papers talk about what we lose post a spinal cord injury. Whereas our NGO, Nina Foundation, talks about our ethos is what we still do possess and continue to have. Fully functional brain to think, a heart full of dreams, and a desire and a dream to live life to the fullest, boldly. With a never see die spirit and willpower to make all the impossibles possible, to scale every mountain practically and metaphorically. Quality of life does is overall well-being, as well as neurological and functional changes over time. Overall well-being conveys how satisfied are we with our lives and life satisfaction parameters. Self-care, managing independently, bladder, bowel, bathing, skin, pain management, fitness, exercise, cooking, activities of daily living, manage the home. In fact, one should allow a friend with spinal cord injury to continue doing what they were doing before their accident. And this is what Nina has been not only responsible for me in terms of what I do, but also all her practices that we transmit to others. Nina Foundation's primary focus is a community of friends with spinal cord injury, especially those who are affected physically, financially, relationship-wise, emotionally and psychologically. The ecosystem in which we live comprises of all kinds of human beings. Indifferent behavior, non-compassionate bad attitude, discriminating, non-cooperative, no proactiveness, no idea of kindness. We get frantic calls. We have, in fact, the first helpline for spinal cord injury. Divorces, family members usurps farming property. They stop taking care, dumps them, leaves them in hospitals and never comes back. Ye KEM hospital mein bhi hota hai. They don't come back to take them back. Women are not made part of the homes, family farms, and don't have a voice in the management of their own house. Sometimes they are even deprived of food choices, marriages, and are not empowered to make decisions of their own lives. Even in urban settings, basic decisions are denied. Then, because of this, there are strained relationships and differences happen. Nina Foundation empowers fellow friends with spinal cord injury to learn to manage their lives. So it is, the word manage is very important. Management is a way forward, because the obstacles and speed bumps faced are so many. Most uncontrollable variables that we tell them, move on. We can't wait for things to be as per our needs. But with ultra confidence, using a mind and a talent, go forward. Through our superior counseling and solutions-oriented approach, we are an extended family. We call it a Nina Foundation family, encouraging all to win and achieve all that they desire. In fact, our support group, which we call the Buddy Group, is our biggest contribution to the movement of spinal cord injury. It's like a link. Okay? And let me tell you, the best of friendships are made in Nina Foundation. Today, if any of us are celebrating anything, the first is someone that you met in Nina Foundation. I would like to, because I started with a movie, I would like to also end with a movie. In the movie, The Miracle Man, it's a black and white film. What worked was the approach of this person who was flying his own aircraft, a small two-seater aircraft, and meets with a spinal cord injury, and years ago in Australia. And it's a real life story. And he was so confident in his mind, the doctors told his wife, "Do tin din ka mehman hai." The nurses and everyone in the hospital said that he's not going to survive. But he was so strong in his mind, and he didn't want all of them to keep saying, you know, that do things and keep saying. So he made a board and kept it next to his bed, hospital bed. And it had the acronym S-N-I-O-P. S-N-I-O-P. And it expands to susceptible to negative influence of other people. He didn't want to corrupt his mind away from his focus of what he so strongly believed in. And actually, during discharge, he got up from his wheelchair and stepped out of the hospital walking, taking baby steps, proving the medical text wrong, proving the doctors wrong. If the mind is capable, then it's even possible to prove the medical books wrong. And actually, Dr. Nina Doshi, my elder sister, and the reason the Atre for Nina Foundation's existence, the purpose of my life, is this. She told me that in Hinduja Hospital. Even though I'm a doctor, I know you can do it. And her mantra is, take stock of your talent, believe in your dreams, be ready to work twice as hard, because our mind is magical. We can achieve all that we wish. Our body cannot limit us. The scientific community and the citizenry, the public at large, can play a humongous role in redesigning the way we approach a person with spinal cord injury, just the way Dr. Yakni is a part of our group, to bring about a radical change in the built environment, healthcare systems, and their attitudes. Each one of us has a circle of influence, and lots can be done for both prevention and for spinal cord injury rehabilitation. We all can proactive manner. We can all participate in a proactive manner. Provide all friends with spinal cord injury a path strewn with rose petals. Can you visualize that? Pink rose petals, and all of us are wheeling together happily with all of you. Thank you so much for this awesome opportunity. Shukriya, Dr. Yakni, Nasi, and Indian Institute of Science. Thank you. Thank you. May I request to show some visuals very quickly and a film. Is that okay?
Yeah, Jogita, please do that.
Dr. Ketna, in the meantime, Dr. Arun Sawant would like to ask one question as they are getting ready.
Sure, please.
Madam, I am really surprised and very impressed with your lecture, and also surprised, in spite of us facing such a huge problem, and how you have sustained with your own spinal cord and smiling face, how could you come over, and what is the molecule that you use between the two of the beats of the spinal cord to make you sturdy? I am not saying you're using calcium apatite, something to make your bones stronger, but then what about the molecule in fluids?
I love that question. Mr. Sawant, thank you for that question. Yeah. I'll tell you what the molecule is. The molecules, and they are dancing molecules, they are divine molecules. One is family.
Oh.
I'm nothing without my family. Absolutely cast in gold, cast in platinum. Family is what sustains all of us. In fact, when I did my PhD and I met the topmost spinal cord surgeons and rehab specialists, Dr. Patrick Kluger from Germany, God bless his soul, recently expired, mentioned that in India, what we don't consider in any part of the world as an ecosystem for rehabilitation, you are fortunate to have. So it is the family, because we are surrounded by them. Nobody will leave us. It is that bond. They are there till we take those baby steps. Secondly, I was extremely fortunate to have an extended family in my team of doctors, surgeons, rehab specialists, homeopath doctors, and you know, today, they are my family, not only my family, but the Nina Foundation family. Because when I and Dhaval decided to set up Nina Foundation, each one of them, Dr. Bhojraj, Dr. Pradhan, Dr. Parinas, Dr. Himanshu Doshi, Dr. Sagre, who is part of Dr. Jacob, who made me, you know, they have seen me over and out, down and out, and they made me walk. They are part of the Nina Foundation family. And each one of us who are going to speak today, please listen to them because they will inspire you much more. Please, Mr. Sawan, stay back.
Thank you, Pat. Excellent. Yeah, we had to learn a lot from you. Yeah. Thank you.
And God, the biggest divine, I think, is our belief in the divine presence. And then just submit and surrender, and you know that things are going to work out, you know. We cannot just, so I think that spiritual connect and the belief also matters a lot. Our values, my parents' values, I think they expired very young. In fact, if you learn about our family history, you know, it's really very tragic. But I think the spirit comes from the values that our parents give us. And I pray that till my last breath, I have that.
Thank you.
Vijay Garde, you have any question?
Sir, please unmute.
Vijay. Okay.
Dr. Garde.
Yeah. Okay, these are the slides of Nina Foundation.
There has to be some sound.
I know. Dr. P.K. Mathur, aap apna audio band kar dijiye, if you are there. हेलो डॉक्टर माथुर, आप अपना ऑडियो बंद कीजिए, ऑडियो म्यूट कर दो, उसका पिकअप आ रहा है।
अच्छा,
Yes, over to Sunita Sanjeevi Mal.
Thanks, Ketna. Thanks, Gayatri. Good evening, everyone. Thanks to the entire team for giving Meena Foundation this opportunity. We are glad to share our thoughts and requirements on rehabilitation for persons with spine injury. We all know that spine injury leaves the person and the near ones and dear ones in a state of shock as it comes without giving any prior notice. And the only way to move ahead is rehabilitation. The recovery and rehabilitation is a process for people with spine injury, and it can be long and a difficult journey. As Ketna mentioned, we have to mentally accept our condition. It takes time to heal and adapt ourselves, to rebuild ourselves after such a drastic event. When we say rehab, it means good physio, good occupational therapy. When it comes to rehab, it is like after the spine injury, we are actually like a baby who needs a nurturing from learning how to use a loo, how to sit, how to stand, how to walk, how to do basic routine of your daily living. So when we go to a therapy center, we are taught how do we move around only with the help of a wheelchair or a walker or a caliper. These devices are very expensive, and so is the therapy session. And to add on to that is the amount of time and traveling cost that we have to pay, because none of the traveling means the transportation system is accessible. And when it comes to spine injury, it can be, as Ketna mentioned, cervical, dorsal, or lumbar. So the higher the level, higher the effect. So when it is cervical, it is below the neck, and dorsal is from the chest below, and lumbar again is a lower region. So the number of activities that we do get limited. We lose our trunk balance, and with the therapy we are taught how do we sit with balancing, and for that we need gym balls, we need different type of devices which are like present in the cities like Mumbai, Madras, Kolkata. But what about the rural places? How do they get therapy? And how does Meena Foundation help? Meena Foundation has had several wellness seminars by renowned doctors like Dr. Sagare, late Dr. Sagare, urologist. He has taught us how to do catheterization, how to keep our self hygiene so that we do not get urine infection. And now same is being continued by Dr. Chirag, who again is a famous urologist. Dr. Uday Khopkar, he helps us in understanding how we can control our pressure sores, bed sores by using proper cushions. Now, when I talk about cushions, again, those are very expensive. So again, a pinch on a pocket. Not only that, the Meena Foundation has also invited Rajiv Virat, who again himself is a wheelchair user, who has trained many of our peers in using skills for transfers. When I say transfers, means transfers from bed to the wheelchair, from the wheelchair to the cars, on the commodes, and each and every transfer takes a lot of effort because we need to use our hands. Just like the way Keshna showed that we do not have enough power in our arms, so it becomes very difficult to learn. And all this is taught through physiotherapy. Not only that, when all these things are learned, we need to understand about spine pain management, about the spasms, about the muscle power that we are losing. So again, Dr. Jacob, Dr. Shekhar Bhojraj, they help us. And of course, Dr. Professor Ketna Mehta, who connects each member with a proper mentor who keeps giving us opportunity, and not only us, to each and every member to overcome their fears and grow in life. The most important therapy is occupational therapy. In India, very few people are aware about the importance of occupational therapy. when I say occupational therapy, it's not only about training you in switching your job profile so that you can become financially independent. It is also about doing your daily activity, such as wearing your clothes, combing your hair. Not only that, you can't even, you know, zip your pants many a times. So they use different type of devices and they train you how you can be independent. They use a simple rubber band and they teach you how you can hold a spoon or a comb and do your daily activity and be independent. They teach us how to use a transfer board so that we can easily transfer from the bed to the wheelchair. So these devices make our life easy. For that matter, even a simple reacher, that helps us, because that helps us in picking up things from the floor, arranging your wardrobe, and not only that, at times to switch on and switch off your lights. So these simple devices help you become independent. Only once you are independent, you start living with dignity. And each and every step done at the rehab center, at the occupational therapy, helps you how you can move ahead. And Nina Foundation plays an important role again by organizing fun events. The way you saw Antakshri, we have many such events, and we have sports camp. Not only that, we have competitions so that, you know, we get motivated. We have sessions on yoga, dance, ramp walks, outbound programs, as recreation is again a very important thing for each and every person. Forget a person with spine injury. So Nina Foundation encourages us. Now, when I say sports, we use again assistive devices there. We use sports wheelchairs. We have separate wheelchairs for basketball, badminton, lawn tennis. We also have different type of devices so that we can hold the rackets well. And that is what helps us. And of course, Oliver will be talking more about the sports rehab. Adding to that, aquatherapy. Aquatherapy is one of the best fun-filled therapy, because in that, we have all the physical therapies that we do in a physio, but in this, our body becomes lighter when we are in water. So the fun of doing the exercises increases. It helps again in reducing your spasms, stiffness, and develops your muscles. It also helps you increase your balance strength. That again is something which is very important. If we have swimming pools with toys and a bigger changing room, we can do aqua therapy at a very reasonable cost. So therapy will become fun at a reasonable cost. And as Ketna mentioned, we have Nina Foundation WhatsApp group, which plays again a very important role. Nina Foundation family, where each one of us share our achievements, our issues, and our peers get encouraged and find solutions to their problems. That is how we move ahead in life. All these therapies can really change life of a person with spine injury. We at Nina Foundation dream to have a world-class rehab center that will change life of thousands of peers of persons with spine injury. Thank you, Sunita Sancheti, 34 years of spine injury experience. Over to Mohammed Sheikh.
Namaskar. मुझे इस बात का इंतहाई खुशी और मसरत है कि मैं इतने प्रेस्टिजियस और शानदार फोरम का हिस्सा बना। थैंक्स नीना फाउंडेशन, आपने मुझे मौका दिया। आज जिस विषय पे बात करनी है, जिस विषय पे बात हो रही है, वो रिहैबिलिटेशन और उसकी इम्पोर्टेंस के ऊपर है। लेकिन इससे पहले कि मैं इस पे एक केस स्टडी बताऊं, मैं ये बताना चाहता हूं कि ईश्वर ने हमको एक बहुत बड़ा वरदान ये जिंदगी दी है, लेकिन कभी कभी ऐसा होता है कि हम इस वरदान को अपनी जाती मिल्कियत समझकर इसके ऊपर अत्याचार कर बैठते हैं, इसके ऊपर जाति कर बैठते हैं, तो हमारी इस शानदार और खूबसूरत जिंदगी के ऊपर ग्रहण लग जाता है, जिसको दूसरे अल्फाज में पैराप्लेजिक होना भी कह सकते हैं। ऐसे ही एक बदकिस्मत नौजवान की केस स्टडी है, जो सांता क्रूज मेलन सबवे के बाजू में झोंपटपट्टी में रहने वाला, जिसका नाम किशन मांडवकर है। 21 साल की उम्र उसकी है और वो अपने दोस्त के यहाँ 16 सितंबर को बर्थडे मनाने के लिए जाता है। बर्थडे मनाने के बाद बारिश का सीजन ख़त्म हो रहा था, आखिरी दिन थे, तो वो बर्थडे पार्टी से वापस आ रहा था, क्योंकि स्लिपरी एरिया है, वो सबवे के नीचे जो ब्रिज है उसके नीचे बड़ा गटर है, उसके साइड में से वो घर पे आ रहा था, क्योंकि झोंपड़पट्टी में रहता है तो झोंपड़पट्टियों के छपरे प्लास्टिक के रहते हैं, तो आवाज़ बारिश की रहती है तो दूसरे की आवाज़ सुनने में नहीं आती, तो वो गटर के अंदर गिर गया, पैर स्लिप होके जहाँ से वो चल रहा था उधर से गटर के अंदर गिर गया। गटर 13 फीट नीचे है और बारिश का टाइम है, पानी है उसमें। सुबह तक, रात के 12 बजे गिर गया वो, और सुबह तक वो गटर में ही रहा। सुबह जब एक कचरा उठाने वाला, कचरा चुनने वाला वो गटर के बाजू से जा रहा था, बाटलियां वगैरह चुनने वाला, तो उसने अंदर से आवाज़ सुनी, तो उसने देखा कि उसमें एक नौजवान पड़ा है। उसने आवाज़ दिया, पूछा नाम वगैरह, तो उसने बोला मेरा नाम किशन है, मैं इधर बाजू में राजीव गांधी पार्क है उसके बाजू में रहता हूँ। तो वहाँ पे उधर जाके उनके घर वालों को बताया, तो वो घर वाले भाग भाग के आए और उसको जैसे तैसे वो गटर में से निकाला, कपड़े वपड़े साफ किए, तो और उसको बोल रहे हैं चलो अभी घर पे, लेकिन वो खड़ा नहीं हो पाता है, वो उठ नहीं सकता है, तो वो बोल रहे हैं इसको क्या हो गया। तो जैसे तैसे करके 2-4 लोगों ने उठा के उसको अपने घर पे लेके गए। घर पे लेके जाने के बाद किसी ने उनको मशवरा दिया कि घर में तो बैठने की जगह है ही नहीं, तो इसको हॉस्पिटल ही लेके जाते हैं, तो उसको कूपर हॉस्पिटल लेके गए। कूपर हॉस्पिटल में वो लोगों ने बोला इसके लिए यहाँ पे पर्याप्त इलाज इस टाइम नहीं है, तो आप उसको बाला साहेब ठाकरे हॉस्पिटल लेके जाइए। तो वहाँ पे लेके गए, वहाँ पे उसका MRI वगैरह हो गया, तो MRI करने के बाद उसका मालूम पड़ा कि उसका D12L1 स्पाइनल वर्टिब्रा फ्रैक्चर हो गया है, तो उसकी वजह से उसका ये बेम्बी के नीचे का भाग पूरा बेकार हो गया है। तो घर वालों ने अपनी गरीबी का रोना वगैरह रोया डॉक्टरों के सामने कि हम तो कुछ भी नहीं कर सकते, हमारा मदद कैसा होएगा। तो वो लोगों ने राजीव गांधी आरोग्य योजना के तहत उसको फ्री में ऑपरेशन किया, उसका वर्टिब्रा स्टेबलाइज किया, तो उसके बाद उनको बोला इसको तुम घर पे लेके जाओ। अभी घर वालों को परेशानी ये थी, घर पे लेके जाएंगे तो घर तो है नहीं, क्योंकि जो घर में वो उससे पहले रहता था वो उसके भाई का औरत का घर था, भाई ने लव मैरिज किया था एक मद्रासी लड़की के साथ, वो मद्रासी लड़की को उसकी माँ ने उसकी गलती के बावजूद भी वो घर दे दिया था, झोंपड़ा दिया था, तो उसमें वो तीनों चारों साथ में रहते थे। तो जब भी वो स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजरी उसका हो गया, तो उसके बाद उन्होंने बोला आप इधर नहीं रह सकते, क्योंकि उसके घर में 11 और 12 साल की लड़की है उसके भाई के घर में, तो उसके सामने कपड़ा सा निकालना, वो करना, ये करना, तो ये पॉसिबल नहीं है, तो बाहर निकाला। तो बाहर वो रोड पे रहता था। हमारा एक पेशेंट जो नीना फाउंडेशन के साथ में जुड़ा हुआ है, सुरेंद्र कसारे, यहाँ मैं ये मेंशन करना जरूरी समझता हूँ कि वो भी D12L1 का पेशेंट है, लेकिन नीना फाउंडेशन की मदद से और इनकी सहायता से वो इंटरनेशनल क्रिकेट खेलने का सौभाग्य पाया। वो इंटरनेशनल व्हीलचेयर क्रिकेट टीम का हिस्सा है अपने इंडिया का। तो उन्होंने नीना फाउंडेशन को इन्फॉर्म किया, तो मैडम ने हमको फ़ोन किया कि कोई क्रिश्चियन वगैरह नाम का कोई लड़का है जो ऐसा लावारिस पड़ा है, तो उसको देख के आ जाओ। तो मैं सांता क्रूज अगले दिन सवेरे गया, तो मैंने देखा ब्रिज के नीचे तो कोई मेरे को दिख नहीं रहा है, ऐसा बगलर वगैरह ये बाटली वाटली पीने वाले लोगों को मैंने देखा। मैं बोला इधर किशन कौन है, तो वो लोगों ने बोला वो कोने पे वो बेंच पे जो पड़ा है वो किशन है, वो गिर गया है तो उधर उसके घर वालों ने उसको छोड़ के गए। मैं उधर गया तो मैं देखा वो मक्खियों की वजह से, मक्खियां उसके ऊपर इतनी मंडरा रही है, इतनी उसको मक्खियां बैठ रही है कि वो मेरे को तो ऐसा लगता है कि वो जिंदगी का सबसे सबसे खतरनाक जंग वो टाइम पे लड़ रहा था। वो मक्खियों को भगा नहीं पाता था क्योंकि वो तो उठ नहीं सकता, और उसके कपड़े वगैरह दो तीन दिन से उसका टॉयलेट वगैरह भी उसी में कपड़े में हो गया, और पीछे उसको जख्म भी हो गया है, खाना नहीं कुछ नहीं। तो उधर मैं बोला तुम्हारा नाम किशन है, उसने बोला हाँ मेरा नाम किशन है। मैं बोला मैं नीना फाउंडेशन से, हम आप जैसे लोगों का मदद करते हैं, तो मैं मुझे आप अपना भाई समझो, हम आपका मदद करेंगे, लेकिन तुम्हारी सपोर्ट की सहायता की हमको ज़रूरत है, तुम अगर कॉपरेट करेगा तो हम तुम्हारी मदद करेंगे। तो वो बेचारा उठ के बोला मेरे को बैठने का है, मैं आपके साथ बात करूंगा। तो मैंने उसको उधर से उठाया, दूसरी जगह ले जाके किसी ने हॉस्पिटल वालों ने उसको व्हील कर दिया था वो टाइम पे, तो उधर उसको बिठाया। ऐसा बिठाने में उसके पीछे का जो जख्म था उससे मेरा पूरा पेंट भर गया, वो पीप वगैरह लग गया पूरा। मैं बोला अरे तुम्हारे को पीछे टॉयलेट वगैरह हो गया, बोला नहीं वो जख्म हो गया है। तो जैसे तैसे उसको व्हील चेयर में बिठा के, तो उसने ऐसा मेरे को बताया कि मेरा एक भाई है, मेरा बाप है, मेरी भाभी है, मेरा बाप सन एंड सैंड होटल में बर्तन धोता है। बर्तन इसलिए धोता है क्योंकि रात को उधर रहने को उसको मिलता है, घर नहीं है। मेरे भाई को उसकी औरत की वजह से जो घर मिला है उसमें बाप भी नहीं रह सकता है, मैं भी नहीं रह सकता, मैं तो घर में बाहर सोता था, लेकिन अभी ऐसा हो गया तो घर में रहना पड़ेगा, वो तो घर में लेते नहीं है। तो मैं उसके लिए डॉक्टर केतना मेहता जी को फोन किया, मैं बोला ऐसी ऐसी परिस्थिति है। तो उन्होंने मेरे को बिंदास बताया हम क्या कर सकते हैं, तुम्हारा सोच क्या बोल रहा है, तुम्हारा अनुभव क्या बोल रहा है, हम क्या कर सकते हैं, हम वो सब कुछ करने के लिए रेडी है, लेकिन क्या कर सकते हैं वो पूरा पिक्चर उधर से तुम हमारे को पेश करो। तो मैंने उनको बताया, पहले ये सुझाव दिया कि उसको रिहैबिलिटेशन सेंटर में भेजना। तो उसमें हमारे को ये दुश्मनी आई कि जिस भी रिहैबिलिटेशन सेंटर में हम उसको एडमिट करने के लिए बात करने जा रहे हैं, तो वहाँ पे बोल रहे हैं उसके साथ में एक घर वाला होना ज़रूरी है जो उसका ध्यान दे दे, केयर टेकर। तो अभी केयर टेकर का प्रॉब्लम है, घर वाला तो कोई साथ देने के लिए तैयार नहीं। अभी हम अगर उसको कहीं पे लेके जाएंगे तो घर वालों की अनुमति नहीं है, हम तो अपनी मर्जी से उसको उठा नहीं सकते थे उधर। तो फिर हम लोगों ने मिल के ये मशवरा किया कि मैं हर अल्टरनेट डे उसको वहाँ पे ही जाके उसका साफ सफाई, उसका सब रिहैबिलिटेशन जो भी प्रोसेस है, क्योंकि मैं पिछले 16-17 साल से रिहैबिलिटेशन के काम में हूँ, मेरी औरत भी पैराप्लेजिक है, उसका रिहैबिलिटेशन भी मेरे जरिए से ही हुआ, तो इस चीज़ से मैं वाकिफ था। तो ये समझा कि मैं उधर जाके उसको रिहैबिलिटेशन के प्रोसेस से गुजारूँ। तो वहाँ पे हर अल्टरनेट डे में जाता था, तो उसका कपड़ा उसका गादी में लेके गया, उसका व्हीलचेयर का, क्योंकि उसका बेड शोर हो गया था तो उसको व्हीलचेयर का कुशन में लेके गया। तो पहले तो उसको साफ सफाई वगैरह, वो ऐसा लगे कि वो इसी दुनिया में रह रहे हैं, तो उनको साफ सफाई वगैरह उधर बाजू में म्यूनसिपलिटी का एक बाथरूम है उसमें ले जाके उसको नहलाया। तो उसके बाद उसको साफ सफाई लगा, तो उसने मेरे को बताया मैं बहुत खुश हूँ आप मुझे मिले ऐसा ऐसा। मैंने बोला मैं नहीं मिला, नीना फाउंडेशन मिल गई ऐसा, ये तुम्हारा नसीब है। इस तरह मैं उसके साथ में चार महीने तक मैं उसके साथ में रिहैबिलिटेशन का ये काम करता रहा। तो इसके दौरान उनको
नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज शो जोगिता शो द नेक्स्ट स्लाइड। या
हाँ, तो जब ही हॉस्पिटल से उसका
नेक्स्ट ये
सुरेंद्र कसारे है जो नीना फाउंडेशन से जुड़े हुए हैं, जिन्होंने हमको पता दिया ये किशन के बारे में। नेक्स्ट प्लीज
यूसुफ भाई बोलते जाइए आप।
हाँ
नेक्स्ट।
तो जब हमारा ये रिहैबिलिटेशन का प्रोग्राम चलता रहा तो हमारे को ऐसा उम्मीद आया, तो उसका बेड शोर वगैरह भी थोड़ा हील हो रहा था, तो उसका ड्रेसिंग का सामान वगैरह सब हमारे इधर से हम लेके जाते थे। उसका ड्रेसिंग वगैरह करने से उसका जब जख्म ठीक हो गया तो मैंने उसको थोड़ा एक्सरसाइज करना चालू कर दिया, उसको एएफओ जो नीचे एंकल का वो सपोर्ट के लिए लगता है, नी ब्रेस लेके गया, जूता लेके गया, और उसको प्रॉपरली रिहैबिलिटेशन का काम और उसको काउंसलिंग भी, उसके घर वाले और जो आजू बाजू में जो वो नशा करने वाले रहते थे उनसे भी मैंने मदद लिया उसको सपोर्ट करने में। वो भी कभी कभी वॉकर पकड़ते थे, ऐसा करते थे जो आजू बाजू में रहते थे। नेक्स्ट प्लीज। तो इस तरह उनको खड़ा करके थोड़ा थोड़ा हमने उसको पैर पे चलने का साहस दिया और इस तरह वो वॉकर पे आ गया। वॉकर पे आने के बाद उसको ये उम्मीद थी कि वो वॉकर पे चल के बाहर जाके, वो पहले भी शर्ट वगैरह का काम, ऐसा धागा वगैरह का काटने का काम किसी कंपनी में, तो वहां पे जाने के लिए उन्होंने बोला था। लेकिन इतने में ऐसा हो गया कि म्युनिसिपैलिटी वालों ने बोला कि भाई आप इधर रह नहीं सकते, म्युनिसिपैलिटी का जगह है। आवाज आ रही है, आवाज किसने?
आदित्य उनावनी।
नेक्स्ट प्लीज। तो इस तरह 2019 का इख्तिताम होते एंडिंग 2019, म्युनिसिपैलिटी ने उधर मना किया कि आप इधर नहीं बैठ सकते हैं, तो हम बहुत परेशान हो गए, अभी इसको क्या करें। तो ऐसे में हमने पूरा जोर लगाया कि इसको हम कहीं पे रख सकें, लेकिन कहीं पे भी ऐसा इंतजाम नहीं हो पाया क्योंकि ये कोविड का स्प्रेड फैल ही रहा था। तो वो टाइम पे फिर हमारे ध्यान में आया, मैं एक और पेशेंट जिसका नाम दीपक था, वो भी अनाथ था, वो शांतिदान में था, नीना फाउंडेशन के सपोर्ट से मैं उसको हफ्ते में 2 दिन वहाँ पे रिहैबिलिटेशन का थोड़ा सहायता करने के लिए जाता था। तो उधर मेरी थोड़ी पहचान थी, तो बड़ी पहचान तो यत्ना जी की थी शांतिदान में, तो उधर वो जितने भी सर हैं उनको पहचानते हैं। तो उन्होंने उधर बताया कि हम इधर ऐसे लोगों को लेते हैं जो अनाथ हो, जिनके पास एनओसी हो, पुलिस का एनओसी, हम वो कृष्ण को लेंगे इधर, लेकिन उसके साथ में उसका एनओसी लाना पड़ेगा। तो मैंने 2-3 दिन पुलिस स्टेशन संता क्रूज में जाके उनको बहुत विनती किया, उनको रिक्वेस्ट किया कि सर ये अनाथ है, घर वाले तो है, लेकिन उन्होंने उसको फेंक दिया। उन्होंने बोला हम उसको सर्टिफिकेट नहीं दे सकते। तो फाइनली मैं वो जो उधर SHO था उनको मैं बताया इसके लिए हमको क्या करना पड़ेगा कि इसको आपसे NOC मिले। तो उन्होंने बताया कि तुम्हारे संस्था और तुम्हारे खुद से जो इसको इधर लेके आया, मैं उसको पुलिस को लेके गया था। नेक्स्ट प्लीज। तो वो लेके जाने के लिए हम NOC देंगे, लेकिन तुमको ये पूरा जिम्मेदारी लेना पड़ेगा, तुम्हारी संस्था और तुमको ये जिम्मेदारी लेना पड़ेगा कि इसको कोई भी हानि नहीं पहुंचेगी, इसका जान सुरक्षित रहेगा। तो उसके बाद हमने उसको, हमारे घर का पेपर वगैरह और हमारे पास लेटर था, तो हमने वो शो किया, तो उसके बिहार पे उन्होंने हमको NOC दे दिया। इस तरह उनको 22 फरवरी शाम को मैंने रिक्शा में बिठाया और सांता क्रूज से ले जाके उनको शांतिदान बोरीवली में उनका एडमिशन हो गया और उनकी लाइफ यूं समझ लीजिए कि सुधर गई। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज। हाँ, ये अभी है वो, अभी उनका, अभी वो हाथ छोड़ के भी ऐसा थोड़ा कोशिश करते हैं चलने की, और आज ही उनका मेरे को रिक्वेस्ट आया, मैं वीडियो डालूंगा नीना फाउंडेशन के ग्रुप में, उन्होंने आज ही मेरे को रिक्वेस्ट किया कि मैं लकड़ी पे चलना चाहता हूँ, एक लकड़ी पे आप मेरे मदद के लिए आ जाइए। तो मैं बोला मैं रिक्वेस्ट को आगे करता हूँ। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड प्लीज। हाँ, ये ऐसा हाथ छोड़ के खड़ा रहते हैं, तो उसको पूरी उम्मीद है। नेक्स्ट। ये पहले का फोटो उनका, जब भी मेरे को वो बेंच पे साफ सफाई करने के बाद, ये नहलाने के बाद है, इससे पहले की हालत तो इसकी बहुत ही बुरी थी बेचारे की। तो अभी फिलहाल ये नॉर्मल इसमें है, इसमें कोई मतलब डिप्रेशन नहीं है, कुछ नहीं है। जब भी वो फ़ोन करता है तो बहुत प्यार से मेरे साथ में बात करता है, रोज़ मेरे को फ़ोन करने के लिए बोलता है। मैं बोला अरे उधर तुम्हारे से ये फ़ोन ले लेंगे, क्योंकि उधर शांतिदान में जो दूसरा कोई आजू बाजू वाला रहता है कंप्लेंट करता है तो फिर उनका फ़ोन अलाउड नहीं करते। तो अभी वो खुश है उधर, ये नीना फाउंडेशन की सौगात है ऐसे लोगों का मदद करके। ऐसे नहीं तो मैं इस चीज़ को थोड़ा और विस्तार करना चाहता हूँ कि अगर कोई पैराप्लेजिक हो जाता है तो पैराप्लेटिक होने के बाद अगर वो अपर सोसाइटी का भी हो, हाई फाइनेंशियल बैकग्राउंड का भी हो, तो भी घर वालों को उसको संभालना मुश्किल होता है। अगर एक नॉर्मल इंसान को हॉस्पिटल लेके जाना है, उसको सर में दर्द है, पेट में दर्द है, कोई भी तकलीफ है, तो जो काम उसको 100 रुपये में होएगा, अगर पैराप्लेजिक को वही हॉस्पिटल लेके जाना है वही सर दर्द के लिए, उसको उसी काम के लिए 1000 रुपये खर्च होते आ जाते हैं, क्योंकि उसको आदमी लोगों का सपोर्ट लगता है, गाड़ी स्पेशल करना पड़ता है और घर वाले सब उसके साथ बिजी होते हैं। कहने का मतलब ये है कि पूरा घर उसके साथ में कम्प्लीटली डिप्रेशन में आ जाता है और फाइनेंशियली डिवेस्टेड हो जाता है और डिस्टर्ब हो जाता है। तो ऐसे लोगों का, जैसे किशन है, मैं ऐसे और 10 लोगों का केस स्टडी बता सकता हूँ जिनको नीना फाउंडेशन के सपोर्ट के बाद जिंदगी उनके पटरी पे आ गई। थैंक यू नीना फाउंडेशन, थैंक यू मैडम। मैं आखिर में एक शेर पढ़ना चाहता हूँ जो हमारे नीना फाउंडेशन का विजन और इसके मिशन को जाहिर करे। दबा हूँ जिस मैं वो मलबा, मुझे निकालना है, दबा हूँ जिसमें वो मलबा, निकालना है मुझे और अपने को जिंदा निकालना है मुझे। जहाँ से आगे कोई रास्ता नहीं जाता, जहाँ से आगे कोई रास्ता नहीं जाता, वहीं से आगे का रास्ता निकालना है मुझे। थैंक यू, थैंक यू, थैंक यू।
Thank you, Sheikh sir. Shall we play the Oliver's video or we'll move on to Ninu?
Ma'am, there are 3 videos that have been sent of the team members.
We will play Oliver's video, then we will have Ninu, and then question and answers. And if there is time, we'll play those.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So, Jogita, you play the Oliver's.
Yeah.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Oliver D'Souza, and I am currently pursuing my PhD in Organizational Psychology at the University of Canterbury in New Zealand. I apologize for not attending this event live due to the time difference. I will be briefly highlighting the critical importance of sports in the rehabilitation of spinal cord injury survivors. While physical therapy during the initial phase of rehab is vital to restoring and enhancing the functional capabilities of a spinal cord injury survivor, subsequent sports therapy provides a more comprehensive solution to encouraging sustainable physical and social activity once the individual leaves the comfort of their rehab center. Research shows that sports can help an individual to maintain health and prevent chronic diseases such as osteoporosis, cardiovascular diseases, metabolic syndrome, and cancer. Additionally, the benefit of sports also extends to mental health, such as influencing a person's self-concept, self-esteem, self-perceived physical appearance, global self-worth, and ultimately their life satisfaction. Practically, sports is more crucial for socialization and social reintegration. Over the last 2 decades, the Nina Foundation, founded by Dr. Ketna Mehta, has been pivotal in improving the quality of life of spinal cord injury survivors in Mumbai and Maharashtra, as you have perhaps already heard from previous speakers. Unlike other NGOs, the Nina Foundation also provides opportunities and encouragement to participate in sports like wheelchair basketball, wheelchair tennis, marathons, and swimming. This is no easy task, as spinal cord injury survivors must battle several physical and social barriers. For most people living in Mumbai, accommodation-related infrastructure is not wheelchair-friendly, and neither is public transport. Add to that, finding a sports facility that has accessible ramps, elevators, and washrooms is like searching for a needle in a haystack. MENA Foundation does all that and more. It also facilitates individuals keen to pursue sport by providing funds for travel and sporting equipment, whilst also counseling family members. Since 2006, MENA Foundation has empowered its members with spinal cord injury to participate in the Mumbai Marathon. For most of the participants, this is the first time they are stepping out of their homes, and this gives them an opportunity to connect with peers who have battled and overcome several challenges that are plaguing them currently. In 2017-18, MENA Foundation purchased 10 wheelchair basketball chairs and partnered with Mumbai University to facilitate the practice of wheelchair basketball. Subsequently, several girls who took up the sport have represented Maharashtra in the national wheelchair basketball competition and won laurels. They have also made progress and represented India in the international tournaments. In the midst of all these activities, it is important to highlight that individuals with spinal cord injury need personal wheelchairs that are easy to carry while traveling. The MENA Foundation facilitates the purchase of high-end active wheelchairs for those who choose to live life in the fast sporting lane, whilst balancing domestic and vocational responsibilities. Since an active lifestyle for a spinal cord injury survivor can increase the risk of bed sores, ulcers, or friction burns, the MENA Foundation instrumentally funds the purchase of the world's best wheelchair cushions that best buffer this risk. As you can see, MENA Foundation adopts a holistic approach to sports rehab. So what are the other benefits of sports rehab for spinal cord injury survivors? Research also shows that individuals participating in any organized sport were significantly associated with higher rates of employment, even when adjusting for demographic factors. This implies that sports participation is more important from a personal and societal perspective rather than just physical exercise. Other qualitative studies have shown that individuals with spinal cord injury can accrue benefits like socialization, acquisition of knowledge from peers, development of greater health awareness and well-being, weight management, functional development, and independence. Therefore, sports therapy should be considered vital to the individual biopsychosocial development. I hope that I was able to highlight the criticality of sports therapy and the role that MENA Foundation plays in Mumbai and Maharashtra. Allow me to leave you with a little bit of history that further buttresses my argument in favor of sports as a major facilitator of rehab. At the end of World War II, Ludwig Guttmann, a German-born neurosurgeon, became the director of the National Spinal Injuries Center in Great Britain. Dr. Guttmann was a firm believer that participation in sport could improve the physical and psychological wellness of individuals acquiring rehabilitation. He stated that sport is the most natural form of remedial exercise, restoring physical fitness, strength, coordination, speed, endurance, and overcoming fatigue. He also stated that sport has a psychological impact of restoring pleasure in life and contributing to social reintegration. Although parasports have evolved from a tool for rehabilitation to now being considered an elite sport, these principles still apply when considering sports rehab for spinal cord injury survivors. The MENA Foundation, its esteemed trustees and volunteers echo this sentiment and consider sports rehab to be a vital aspect of a spinal cord injury survivor's journey to living life with health, wealth, and dignity. Thank you all and have a great day.
Thank you, Jogita. Over to Neenu, madam.
Good evening, everyone. I'm the last but not the least. Let me not, get into too much of introduction and dive to directly to my topic, which is law and prevention. For that, I have a PowerPoint presentation which I would request to be played, please.
Yeah, just give me a second.
So while the PowerPoint presentation is being played on, we all know that for any cause, issues, and the kind of work that Nina Foundation is doing and many others, you know, law plays a very crucial role. And all that we have seen, Professor Dr. Ketna Mehta and my other friends before me, they have told us about the causes, the impact, and the various stories, the case studies of how it impacts each one's life. But how we can change this is by various ways, is raising awareness, medical treatments, rehab, and so on. But law also and prevention play a crucial and equal part to this. So there was the Persons with Disabilities, which is Equal Opportunities Protection of Right and Full Participant Act 1995, which came into enforcement on February 7, 1996. This law was an important landmark and was a significant step in the direction to ensure equal opportunities for people with disabilities and their full participation in the nation building. The Act provided for both preventive and promotional aspect of rehabilitation, like education, employment, and vocational training, reservation, research, manpower development, and creation of barrier-free environment, rehabilitations of people with disabilities, unemployment, and establishment of homes for people with severe disabilities. Now, this Act, the one at 1995, had seven basic disabilities listed under it: blindness, which is low vision, then leprosy, hearing impaired, locomotor disability, mental retardation, and mental illness. Later, as you can see on my slide, there was this Rights of Persons with Disability Act 2016, which replaced the old one, that is the PWD Act 95. Now, this new bill fulfilled the obligations to the United Nations Convention on the Rights of People with Disabilities, that is UNCRPD, the acronym, to which India has been the signatory. The RPWD Act 2016 came into force from 19th April 2017. And the disability has been defined based on evolving and dynamic concept. And the salient features of the Act were: disability has been defined based on evolving and dynamic concept, and the types of disabilities has increased from the previous existing 7 to 21. And the central government has the power to add more. But however, can we go to the next slide? However, there are, you know, the spinal cord injury has not been included in these 21 disabilities that were added later. So, you know, as you heard Professor Dr. Mehta and other friends, that how much a spinal injury impacts a person's life, the cost of living, the medicines, the UTI issues, treatment, rehab, and all that requires a separate provision which has to be included in the policy. The government and all other authorities should take this up seriously, because spine injury doesn't come only in the locomotive disability, but nor does it fit into any other category, because there is a lot more to it. So we have to have a separate, you know, inclusion under the disabilities list. Next slide, please. So these are some of the, you know, recognized disability heads. And we had the act, which was introduce later on. The next slide, please. Now, along with this policy that, you know, there is a absence of spine injury as a different heading, the one of the impact, like impact on the health and other impacts, that the inaccessibility, because as you can see, Ketna, myself, Oliver, Sunita, we all are wheelchair users. Whether it is a wheelchair user, walker user, cane, crutches, or a person with visual impairment who uses a cane, we all need access, and lack of access has an impact on our education. None of the schools, playgroups, nurseries, anganwadis, colleges, universities, training institutes, none of them have access. Employment, like किसी तरह से हमको कैसे भी उठा के समझो बेसिक एजुकेशन दे दिया, स्कूल गए, कॉलेज के, नाउडेज ऑफकोर्स देयर इज ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन, बट कैसे भी तरह से हमने वो सब कर लिया. द नेक्स्ट इज एम्प्लॉयमेंट, करियर. नाउ नन ऑफ द ऑफिसेज, द वर्क प्लेसेस आर एक्सेसिबल फुल्ली, सो दैट वी कैन वर्क देयर फॉर 8 hours, 9 hours कंफर्टेबली एंड परस्यू आवर करियर्स, अर्न एन इनकम. The government offices, municipal offices, fire station, the police stations, embassies, consulates, passport office, again, none of them are accessible. Banks, ATMs, hospitals, nursing homes, yes, you'll be surprised, even the hospitals, nursing homes, clinics are not accessible at all. Grocery, salons, doctors, dentists, lab tests, you know, the pathology, all of them are inaccessible to us. And most important, again, the recreation, the theater, like now there are new malls coming up every day, new theater, multiplexes, you know, the gaming zones. Nowadays you have these, you know, Smash at Lower Parel you go to. There are various activities emerging. But auditoriums, like I think Sunita, me and Ketna have attempted to go for plays so many times, but we've had to really struggle when we have to go to an auditorium. So there are a lot of these issues which impact our day-to-day life. Now, even the residential buildings, the new townships which are coming, they are gated communities which have so many facilities inside, clubhouses, swimming pool, you name it, you have all those activities inside in a complex. Now, suppose even if we buy, if I or Ketna or Sunita, we buy a flat in one of these new constructed complexes, but are we going to be, you know, stuck to our homes? No, we would like to be part of the society, be part of the celebrations that happen in, you know, in the compound, but can we access those spaces? I don't think so. So all, you know, the inaccessibility, which is the lack of absence of ramps, railings, toilets, separate spaces, parking, everything impacts the non-skid flooring, like, you know, people who use crutches, people who use walkers, canes, you know, the tiles, the flooring is so glazed that you can easily slip and become injured. Like people, we have in our Nina Foundation network, members who have become, have spinal cord injury, who have slipped in their own houses while taking bath, or even in while walking in the house, normal people, they have fell on their back and got spine injury and they are paralyzed for good. Now, can you really imagine, you know, having getting into an accident outside the house is still imaginable, but imagine you're walking in your own house and your life can change within a minute. So we do not, when we design, comes, you know, with the design concept, the architects, the builders, they never really think this deeply. So one has to really raise awareness about this. Now, what is the solution? So prevention is very, very important. Okay. Road accidents, as Ketna had mentioned, road accidents, then swimming, diving, Ganpati Visarjan, Dahi Handi, Stampede, large gatherings, sports, adventure. All these are the one of the major reasons why how a spine injury can happen. So what are the some of the preventions as far as the, you know, the road accidents are concerned? So one can develop crash proof vehicles, you know, where, you know, the collision can be avoided. Then design safety features inside the vehicle, such as the occupants are alerted and they are protected and unharmed. Then there could the road surfaces can be designed, the material used where there is no potholes, and again the accidents or the skidding of the scooter or other vehicles can be avoided. And there could be a burst proof vehicle tires which also cause you know, road accidents, you know, suddenly when the tires burst. So that can be prevented. The other is the falls, like, you know, one of the major reason for spine injury in so many of our members have there have been falls. So many villages are still without regular electricity. The rural roads, they don't have street lighting, you know, so there accidents happen. So we should design vehicles like intelligent buildings which automatically illuminates during the night when there is no light, and they can alert and we can see the surrounding. And so there could be a bomber suit or a similar clothing which, you know, when the fall is occurring, the safety harness or rules are ignored. So a suit would protect the head and the spine, which are the most sensitive area. And a behavioral change campaign such that people actually heed to this before embarking on risky activities. So to avoid falls on smooth surfaces, especially bathrooms, design non-skid flooring, especially for wet surfaces. That is very important. Then sleeping on terraces in rural areas, you know, is again a very common cause. So there should be some kind of design material for edges and parapets for terraces where they self-illuminate and warn people where that they can fall. So to safety fall from stairs, balcony, ladder, we can design special clothing which opens like a parachute or wings, and one can glide down safely. Thirdly, medical field. So a vaccine could be developed and taken as an infant to prevent, you know, spinal cord injury, maybe, you know, these are wishful thinking. Then again, a protective sheath for the spine, like how you have a raincoat which can protect us from which protects us from rain. So that can generally sheath can help help us from the spine injury, something like that. A possibility of spine transplant, nerve transplant, spinal cord transplant maybe. So, you know, something like that. Then something like medical design solution to restore bladder, bowel fertility, bed sores, those kind of muscle tone, you know, something like that can be designed. So because there is so much happening in the medical fraternity, so their imagination is endless. And lastly, the technology again plays a very crucial part these days in every aspect of our life. So something like an early detection wristband, which can be designed and it identifies and alerts the beginning of, you know, TB, cancer. So even spine injury, you know, can be detected. A controllable switch, like a ring finger for bladder and bowel function. Then design technology for avoiding bed sores and create new layer of healthy skin that I've already mentioned. Then an external portable spine cord machine, like a robot which will can support our functions, much like oxygen cylinder used for patients. You know, so this kind of technology, like a crystal ball predictive, you know, analytics, like dangerous accident prone roads and spots, alerts the driver. I mean, there are these signboards you already see on the road, that accident prone zone, please be alert. But something more that can alert, because still people are careless, they do not see the signboards. So something more stronger which can alert the people that there is a, you know, a very accident prone zone that you are entering into. So all these things can be prevented if we collectively work. And INA Foundation has really been running these kind of sensitizing awareness campaigns since 2012 for prevention and inclusion by writing to the WHO through other organizations, you know, holding hands with other organizations. And we have been campaigning for changes because we want the entire ecosystem, like government, science communities, communities like yours, NASI, NGOs, medical fraternity, and law. We want that you to believe and agree with our campaign and raise more awareness, knowledge about prevention, and more rehab centers and assistive technology. And lastly, we seek your support in this because, next slide, please. Because we believe that together we can walk towards a wonderful tomorrow. We cannot do anything in isolation, just you know, from the NGO aspect. We need all the society, everybody, to walk together with us. Last slide, please. So thank you all for listening to us, being patient. And I look forward that a very collective action can we can hope and look forward and work together for a better outcome on this. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Neenu, madam. Madam, shall we play the video or we'll wind up?
Dr. Yakni, there are questions.
Any questions, please? Yes.
The entire team is there.
Anybody has comments, if not questions?
Mr. Vijay
Gardai,
yes, sir.
Vijay
Gardai, if I may, this program has been wonderful because there were so many inputs and from experience, and I really appreciate the such programs to be conducted once in a month or so, so that a lot of people can bring case studies, and they are a good learning for many others. Somebody mentioned about the aging wheelchair, so I was really taken aback. I am 45 years in the wheelchair, and 85 years of age I completed last week. So one can be sure that yes, people can live up to that age. Not unlike the 50 years back when 90% people, 80% people perished in the first 6 months. Coming to the point, I feel that there are a number of points to be taken up separately in each seminar like that. One is about the access movement. Then we can have a focused type of arrangement. A lot of access movement is hampered because people with wheelchairs or such disabilities are not seen outside. And they are not seen outside because there are no facilities. They are stuck to their houses. So this is a kind of vicious circle which has to be broken. And access movement is such that it's not very difficult when so many new structures are being constructed. It's not difficult to make a ramp, suitable ramp of a good gradient Many times I find that ramp for ramp's sake is constructed, and it's such a high gradient that one can't go by himself, or even those pushing the chair have to struggle a little more. So this is one thing that in the building code of practice, or anywhere we can insert, that there should be a ramp for every public buildings, for every new community center, or any public facilities as such, offices, government offices, etc. There has been such a provision on paper, but it has not still been implemented. Second thing is that it is true that spinal injury is such a traumatic experience, and it's only that I've been lucky to be able to go up to the very senior position in the organization. But it requires a tremendous effort on the part of the individual and also the family. It's a more strain on the family, I guess. I was lucky in that respect that I had a wife who was a fantastic person. She was the only girl in the 1962 batch of IAS. At that time, there were very few girls as such, but those times are gone. And it is still very necessary that family support is important, and the families have to be slightly briefed while the patient is in hospital, that what are the things likely to happen, and what the patient may need later on as assistance. So this kind of a preparatory thing is very useful in meeting this kind of emergency in life. This program has been wonderful, and I'm sure that continuation of such seminars with participation of people are going to educate a lot of people and share their experience with this. Incidentally, I may mention, Neenaji has been very kind to insert that announcement in the latest issue of One Life. I had written a book called Coming Back to Normal Life, and Leading a Full Life, and then Retiring Afterwards. But that book is out of print at present after two reprints. Only the Kindle version is available. Do see that. I'm sure that there are a number of answers to many questions raised here, because I got advantage of a very, so to say, you can say, privileged treatment. I was in a senior position in Libya, and that made the things easier that I got treatment in England in the best possible Stoke Mandeville Hospital Annex. So that made a lot of difference, and if one has to see what difference it makes, it's really my life that I have been able to make a difference to my life as such with that treatment. So I always considered myself to be a part of the ordinary society, normal society. And I found that my associates, my organization was really very helpful. I worked for all those years after coming back with Bharat Heavy Electricals. And BHEL has been a very enterprising, very forward-looking type of organization. So I did not have much problem in selling the ideas or working from them. I had almost 500 people working with me, working under me, so to say, but with me. And that was a wonderful experience. So all these kind of things are possible if there is a will to go. I end my this small insertion with a quote from Tolstoy. Tolstoy, the famous Russian author, had written that one of the most difficult but an essential thing in life is to love life, even while one suffers, because life is everything. Life is God, and to love life is to love God. I find this as a very inspiring quote, which I had throughout my rehabilitation period with me, and which really pulled me through all those traumatic experiences. I wish the this particular endeavor continues, and maybe at a later date I am able to speak on a topic with a longer time schedule. Thank you very much. Thank you, Ninaji, for all the assistance and telling me. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Jogita, you wanted to ask something?
Yeah. So I wanted to ask about the onset of work from home culture in the last almost 2 years. Has it improved the chances of employment for disabled people?
Sunita?
Can this I answer is, that?
Yeah, this is a question to me?
No.
I couldn't get the question, please. Could you repeat that?
Neenu is answering that, Dr. Garde.
Yes.
Neenu's answering.
Of course, Sunita and Ketna, you both can add to that. But I just want to strongly put forth my view on this. Yes, work from home culture, online education has definitely increased the chances of employment and education for people with disability. But that is not, at least I personally would like to advocate, because a person's overall personality enhances when they go into the world with the people at large in society. So how much I can learn while working in isolation from my house is not much then versus if I go to a setup, a work setup outside, and I work with a team, with people, the think tank around me, the discussion, the comments, the fun, going for chai, going to the tapri, having team building lunches and team building activities. That adds much more to my knowledge, my experience, and the overall personality. So I would not really agree that, yes, work for technically, work from home has increased the chances, but I hope that is not the culture that follows. I hope that does not happen. Sunita, Ketna, y'all can please add to that.
We have the same opinion, I suppose, that it is very important to step out of the house and be with people.
Yes.
The world is moving towards inclusion. Dr. Yakni has been moving the needle in the education space with the ARC school. So inclusion is when we blend, when we are one, and create one world where differences are celebrated.
Shall I make one or two comments? If anybody else has a question or comment after that?
No, sir, you can.
Okay. First of all, I thank everybody, NASI people who organized, and Institute of Science, very good hosts. I mean, people may threaten to hold further visit programs under you.
Thank you, sir.
So well done. Very well coordinated and orchestrated, I would say that. And then, of course, Ketna and her team in our foundation, they were the backbone of today's presentation, because they were all trying to tell what it is. I have two or three points which came to my mind during this listening to, particularly Vijay Gadreji, so, and also Neenu. You know, they mentioned that there are hardly any societies or cooperative buildings where there are appropriate facilities for wheelchair people to go around. I live in a place, Goregaon East, which is a new society. When we go to the clubhouse area where we have walking tracks, swimming pools and all, we may or may not use, but I find wheelchair people being either taken around or they can themselves go around. I mean, I'll give you an example. Somebody who is about 70 years old himself, his mother is 94, he brings her there. He also makes her walk half a kilometer or so. I tell you, it is very rejuvenating. Looks to me must be very, very, not just entertaining, but rejuvenating to his mother and to himself that he is able to do that. So now, you know, accessibility in general, first of all, it comes through awareness. If we are all in our cocoons, we are able bodies, people think God is in his heaven and everything is fine, then things will not change. Then how do they change? Ketana would remember we were together. I won't name the building where we were, big tower building in Nariman Point. She waits how to go up those four stairs. She had her driver and even some wooden plank just to manage, but the slope was too much. I think it's very embarrassing for our architects and builders to spend not millions, billions of rupees to construct buildings, but not the approach for these people. Second thing is entertainment, of course. I'll come back to accessibility in Japan, where I will end. We were very happy when Kalina, Bombay University people, they helped out. They gave their indoor basketball stadium to Ketana and her friends to play basketball there. Nothing can really recharge the batteries of our, you know, special people. I mean, it's not, first of all, it's not easy to get facilities. It is also not difficult to agree if people have a, you know, bent of mind to do that. Last point, I said awareness, and it also comes through culture of helping others. Japan is number one in this. I've gone several times to Japan. Do you know, in 2018, nobody knew pandemic will come. Nobody knew the Olympics will be delayed by a year. And hardly anybody thought, you must have been reading, that Japanese will be able to complete the Olympics and Paralympics the way they did. Because they are Japanese people, they take care of everything. You know, how the awareness comes? In 2018, a group of four people went around Tokyo imagining where all our guests on wheelchairs will be going around, on the pavements, on the roads, crossing the roads, going to restaurants, to museums. After all, they are coming to not only just to compete in Olympics, also to see Japan. So you'll be surprised, three people on wheelchairs were moving around for weeks. One of them was actually an able-bodied person, but he wanted to be in the wheelchair to feel the pain of it, to the excitement of it. They went to restaurants. There are old restaurants in Japan, Tokyo also, were constructed long ago, and the found toilets are not there on the ground floor. You have to go up first floor. And there were similar other things, but at least they made themselves aware and put it to the government and the organizers of the Olympics. Please let us repair and try to correct. So I think there has to be a will by people. Thank you. Ketana wants to say something.
Yeah. Two things based on what you said. आप हम सबको बुलाइए आपके बिल्डिंग में समोसे के लिए. हम देख लेंगे व्हीलचेयर एक्सेसिबल है कि नहीं. शुक्रिया. सेकंड, फॉर स्पाइनल कॉर्ड इंजरी आई थिंक वेरी फ्यू ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस अंडरस्टैंड दैट देयर हैज टू बी एन अवेयरनेस लाइक दिस बिकॉज इट्स सो इजी टू गेट इनटू द कॉमन areas, then it becomes a very big thing about, you know, that so many changes have to be done. And those little changes, what we are asking for, the change the law, add spinal cord injury, there has to be a good quality of life. That gets missed out because then everyone says it's a very big problem. If you do not mind, I may request you to play two films that we did not play after my keynote address, because here we have an example of how Nina Foundation went to all the big, apparently there are 18 billionaires in Mumbai and such big houses, you know, I will not name them, we all know it. But it took a small organization, All India Women's Conference, to come forward and say, we will give you this community hall. It's how big a hall where we can have a bed. But what Nina Foundation had was a full multidisciplinary team. wanting to offer everything free of cost, the best of spine surgeons, best of physiotherapists, best of orthotists. So may I request you to play Madhu Singh's Jogita, Madhu Singh's video, 1 second, and Bhavna Chheda's video, 1 second, which talks about our OPD. Because I think NASI is in Mumbai, the scientific community in Mumbai, it's very important what Mr. Mohammed Sheikh did under the bridge. It is phenomenal. The one life, it is, why are we searching for life in outer space? Let's not look for aliens. Let's look at how we can improve the quality of life of people here. Thank you.
I have a spine injury that I was scared for. In a foundation OPD is dream come true for all SCN. So free OPD every Wednesday in Mumbai. We have India's best leading doctor attached to our OPD. Under one roof, we have spine specialists, urologists, and homeopathic, full team of physiotherapy and counselor for the patient and patient's entire family. In this COVID time also, we are working through video call and Zoom meeting. With all love and carefully, we are handling this OPD and want to grow this OPD as early as possible. Thank you.
Nina Foundation's mission is to motivate and encourage friends with spinal cord injury, especially those who are poor and economically challenged, living below poverty line. My name is Bhavna Chheda. I am having spinal cord injury since last 21 years. Nina Foundation's team, which listens, understands the problems faced by spinal cord injured people and connects them to the support group who cares for them like a family member. This gives them hope to live a life with dignity and not ever to give up. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, since there are no more activities remaining, may I thank NASI for providing a platform for the first time to such an activity where we have discussed, focused on one disability. But of course, there are other disabilities. You may have epilepsy, you may have type 1 diabetes, you have so many problems. I think a general educative awareness has to be provided to people. They should know about some depth of difficulty. So with these words, I thank Institute of Science, Professor Gayatri, and all her team members have to have done a great job for us. It's not easy, and I mean, it's already going on for more than 2 hours. And the preparatory aspects which went on for the last 4 or 5 days. Thank you so much. I really appreciate all that. And thank you, Ketna, for providing all the knowledge about spinal cord.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you. I would like to propose a vote of thanks officially. I would like to thank Dr. Yakmi and Dr. Hassan for giving us this opportunity to host this wonderful event. Thank you very much, Dr. Ketna Mehta, for her impromptu and very touching talk. It was a really inspirational experiment. I would like to thank Dr. Sumita Sanchita for her physiotherapy insight. It is really a task to look after such patients. Mr. Sheikh, aapka case study bahut acha tha. Aapka contribution to the Nina Foundation is really appreciable hai. I would like to thank Oliver to give insight about the sports rehabilitation. Neenu Kevalani, thank you very much for giving information about the laws and rehabilitation of the spinal cord injury patients. Lastly, I would like to thank Dr. Kobragade, our director, Dr. Thakkar, President Alumni Association, Dr. A.D. Savant, President Golden Jubilee Trust Fund, Dr. Aparna Savant, Dr. Aparna Saraf, for their support, and my dear colleagues, Jogi Ram, Mihir, and Akshay. Thank you very much. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you.
We can break off.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Dr. Yakni. Thank you.
Thank you.